using synthetic chemicals. Super Male Vitality by InfoWars Life is so powerful that I only take half the recommended dose. For a limited time, we are offering 15% off Super Male Vitality at InfoWarsLife.com to introduce you to this powerful supplement. Visit InfoWarsLife.com today to secure your Super Male Vitality. InfoWarsLife.com. Alex Jones here to tell you about how you can help spread liberty worldwide while also enjoying what I have found to be the best tasting 100% organic coffee on the planet. For more than a decade, my favorite coffee has come from the high mountains of southern Mexico, where the Chiapas farmers grow their unique shade-grown Arabica beans. We have now managed to secure these sought-after beans in a highly customized blend. Discover and try a bag of the Patriot Blend 100% organic coffee at InfoWarsLife.com. This coffee gives you a long, smooth pick-me-up for hours without the headaches and heartburn that so many other coffees give me personally. Hands down, this is my favorite coffee, and it's taken us years to secure connections directly to the Chiapas Mexican farmers. Drop by the site today, order a bag or two, and I don't think you're going to be disappointed. Available in original or with our immune support infusion blend, you will be supporting a free press, all the while enjoying a truly great-tasting cup of my favorite coffee. Available at InfoWarsLife.com.
If you are receiving this transmission, you are the resistance. Live from the InfoWars.com studios, it's Alex Jones.
That's right. In a few more minutes with Max Keiser, then we're going to your phone calls on not just Piers Morgan, just another sign that the dinosaurs of the state-run media are collapsing. But they're still delusional as ever. They just double down on their anti-gun, anti-family, anti-liberty, pro-war, pro-police state rhetoric. Here are some of the headlines up on InfoWars.com. Obama seizes control of late-night TV. Supreme Court refuses to hear Second Amendment case. More news breaking. Obama is firearms salesman of the year with some of the key graphs. Piers Morgan admits gun control advocacy led to show being axed. Democracy murdered by protests. Ukraine falls to intrigue and violence. Now they're talking about other countries falling along Russia's border. Ron Paul says leave Ukraine alone. The West should stay out of it. I agree. Ukraine puts out a warrant for the president. That is just some of the news up on InfoWars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. If you look at DrudgeReport.com, it's Putin. The Winter Games are over. And continuing, the games are over. Will Putin take the gloves off? For more than 2 weeks while Russia hosted the Winter Olympics, President Vladimir Putin did his best to show the world that he and his country have a soft side. Now that the games are over, Western governments are concerned the smile will disappear and the gloves will come off. That's why they launched the attack during it, the Western Soros attack during it against Ukraine. In Russia, tug of war with Europe over the fate of Ukraine. The circus artists, dancers, and flag bearers hardly had time to leave the stadium after the closing ceremony before Russia announced it had recalled its ambassador from Ukraine from consulates in Moscow. Russian state television said they don't accept the new government as legitimate. And Western governments are saying, do not launch your military into the country. You've got the eastern area that's mainly Russian citizens. You've got the West that was more allied with Germany in World War II. And I understand they have a beef with Russia, but they should know that the euro will suck them dry. And the euro are the ones that spent $5 billion with the State Department fomenting this. And so I'm sure from different perspectives, there's different reasons for this. The point is the detonator, the initiator on all this is the West. Now, I don't know Max Keiser's take on this, but I know he's lived all over Europe and covered it. So we'll get his take on it. But, you know, I mean, I'm for the Arab Spring, except it got hijacked and in some cases stirred up by the West. What is your view, Max, of what's happening right now in the Ukraine?
Well, you know, Russia, Iran, and China, we've talked about this before. They have a mutual defense pact, I guess you could call it, or it's the Shanghai Cooperation Agreement. And, China, Russia, and Iran share something very interesting in that they don't have central banks that are controlled by the Fed or the IMF or the World Bank. So there's enormous pressure by the central banks of the West to seize these operations of Iran, Russia, and China, because that's a threat to the central bankers. And the central bankers in the West are what feed those enormous bonuses on Wall Street by printing up those trillions of dollars of the quantitative easing. But because Iran, China, and Russia have economies that, well, in the case of Russia, of course, they have huge natural resources, and they don't really need to have a financialized Ponzi scheme like you have on Wall Street. So they don't really need to be part of the confederation of corrupt central banks, whether it's the ECB, the Bank of England, Bank of Japan, the Federal Reserve Bank. So that's where the tension is. And the situation in Ukraine, obviously, it's another hit piece by, you had John McCain down there in the CIA looking to stir trouble. They're looking to seize any assets they can and fund some local CIA-sponsored folks, and game on. Same thing we've seen in Central America, South America, North Africa. This is the global insurrection against banker occupation. As we've been talking about on your show for years, it's just been getting larger and more violent as the central bankers want to protect their monopoly in printing fiat nonsense and giving themselves huge bonuses and letting everyone else starve. What's interesting is that in the Ukraine, on the economics front, the price of food has been going up. We've talked to you on your show before, Alex, about when the price of food as a percentage of disposable income gets to around 40%, there's usually some kind of violent revolution. We saw it in the Arab Spring. We see it now in Ukraine. We see it in historically going back to the French Revolution. So that's another byproduct of this money printing, is that the poor people who are exposed face to face with rising food costs as a percentage of disposable income, when it gets to a certain level, they just go into the streets because they've got nothing.
Exactly, Max, but that's the problem. They know when these countries are going to blow up, so the West then triggers its revolution to make sure a real revolution doesn't happen. And so instead of the Russian allied government that's obviously got problems, they're now going to go with the EU, who's already saying they're going to put the Ukraine under debt. I mean, this is...
Yeah, exactly. That's exactly right. So I'm saying that's what you have at work here. And just, you know, going back to the media collapse in America for a second and the Piers Morgan story, I just wanted to also bring to your attention the comments of Alec Baldwin, who's a friend of mine for 30 years, who just came out today and slammed MSNBC and Huffington Post, the so-called liberal left media in America, as a sham. He called Rachel Maddow basically two-faced. So this is a major admission by somebody who's a huge media presence in the U.S.
Yeah, the headline is Goodbye to Public Life.
Yeah, well, if you read the details, he's saying that MSNBC is a sham. Rachel Maddow is two-faced. Huffington Post is a sham. They're all basically working for these slime balls at the center of the media cartel. What about the story last week, Alex, of Comcast extorting from Netflix a fee? You remember net neutrality? We didn't want anyone like a Comcast to come in and turn the internet into HBO or turn it into pay-per-view. We wanted it to be end-to-end,
exactly,
and open and free. Now, of course, Comcast has had their way. Netflix is going to have to raise their prices. If your show, because it's on the internet, you're going to have to pay extortion money to your provider of internet services, or suddenly people trying to get Prison Planet and AlexJones.com, it's going to be slow. They'll put in the slow.
Exactly, and people are already paying for their download via their internet service. These companies claiming they need to charge somebody for access to their grid is total fraud. And so they're coming after net neutrality. They're coming internet taxes.
Yeah, but they've already done it. Instead, you know, Aaron Swartz died for the sins of the corporocracy. But, you know, you're coming to Oxford University, Alex. We're doing an interview with you when you're in London. You're going to be taking a victory lap in the United Kingdom. You were here a few months ago. You were on television. You busted the ratings charts of all these shows that never had ratings like with you were on the show ever in their history on the BBC. Now Piers Morgan is dead. The Wicked Witch is dead. You're coming back here for a victory lap, much deserved victory lap in the UK. We want to document it. We want to be there.
Yeah, I'm flattered that Oxford has me speaking at their main end of winter keynote to the faculty and private members of Oxford Hall.
Yeah, well,
there.
They didn't invite Piers Morgan. You know, they didn't invite a slime bucket like Piers Morgan because he's...
No, but let me ask you, why do you think the faculty is inviting me to come address them? That's bizarre.
Because you're a media maven. I mean, you've redefined public media. in the world.
That's what they said in their letter. They said, I'm changing the media, the way the media works. That's what they want me to speak on.
Absolutely. I mean, you've been an inspiration to MaxKaiser.com. You've been an inspiration to our work on television. You've been, people like Luke Rutkowski, who's one of the greatest journalists in the world right now. Where do you think he came from? He came out of the Alex Jones world. So now you're taking a much-deserved victory lap. And I think there's going to be, it'd be on my
show. Well, I do like England. I got to tell you, I really love England. That's why I said I'd come back. Because I love the Salisbury Plain. I was going to live somewhere. Gosh, that's beautiful. Well, listen, Max, we'll talk to you for a full hour soon if you can do it on everything in the world. Thank you so much for popping in.
And my pleasure, Alex. Bye-bye.
There goes Max Kaiser. Now, the guy from Pakistan hung up. He's only been on hold 20 minutes, bro, and I know if he can get back in, I want Muhammad on because I want to get his take internationally on dinosaur media collapsing. But I want to quantify this. Piers Morgan, 350,000 viewers a night on average. This show, 3 million. Terrestrially, 3 million on AM and FM stations. But people are like, oh, that's AM and FM. It's people. They're listening. InfoWars, million visitors a day, sometimes more. We're not putting on airs. We're not on these big power trips. When we have audiences, how many times bigger is that? That's an audience like 6, 7, 8 times bigger than Piers Morgan's? I mean, he's pathetic. So he never collapsed. He never exploded, folks. It's an illusion. It's mind control. We're going to go to your calls. Phil, Lisa, Eric, Brian, Mike here in just one moment. First off, we are listener supported. We don't have Monsanto advertising like on every CNN show or MSNBC or Eli Lilly with all their psychotropic drugs. We don't have Adderall advertising here, Speed for Kids. We don't have government ads on here. We don't get stimulus money like MSNBC or NPR. We get funded by the people listening and watching. This is radio. It's really a radio show, but it's grown into TV over the last decade. I started out in TV. So when you buy the books, the videos, the T-shirts, the super high-quality non-GMO heirloom seeds, the lowest prices at the International Seed Center at InfoWarsStore.com, you get the Molon Labe Pro Gun shirts, whatever it is, of over 500 great items, you are funding our operation Voting Free Will. So get the new Molon Labe, the most handsome Molon Labe shirt out there. Get the 50 cal bottle breacher made by Navy SEALs from made in 1776.com. The T-shirts made in America. Get the fluoride shield with the nascent iodine and five other key things to strip out the heavy metals and toxins. It's really the best deal on the site. Get the survival shield proprietary nascent iodine that has done. Look at me. Folks, put me on screen. I am working out less than I was 6 months ago. Because once you get fat and out of shape, even if I was swimming 2 miles and jogging, 3 or 4 miles every other day, I got healthier, my heart, blood pressure, all that real, real good, but still had blubber. Soon, I'm going to take my shirt off, folks. I mean, sitting down, I barely have a little pot belly now. It's like a third of what it was. I look at me. I still got a big round pumpkin head, but I mean, I look good. People are like, whoa, man, what's going on? And I'm telling you, it is the survival shield. Like nothing else out there. I mean, if I forget and don't take it 3 times a day, and I take a little bit more than this recommended dose of this, then I just absolutely feel it. It's so incredible compared to all the other iodine out there, and you're helping fund our operation. So that's at InfoWarsLife.com. See, made in 1776.com, InfoWarsLife.com, they just are URLs that lead you to subpages on InfoWarsStore.com to find the Made in America apparel, made in 1776.com, to find the 3 supplements we put out. We could have put out already 100, but we go slow. Only bringing you the best. You go to InfoWarsLife.com. But InfoWarsStore.com will get you there, and that's how we fund the operation. So thank you all for your support. Become a PrisonPlanet.tv nightly news member, $5.95 a month. Get 11 memberships you can share with your username passcode. That just pays for the bandwidth and the cameras and the crew. And then it's on Roku and Boxy and a bunch of other platforms, dominating those platforms. We're in the top 5 of all those platforms. iTunes won't really let us on there. There's all sorts of stuff. They won't let Obama Deception go on there, even though it's all the specs. They took our money twice and then, to quote, spec it and then refused it. So, I mean, we've gone through a lot here, folks, but it's an uphill battle, but we've now reached the top of the hill. Now we are like a juggernaut. We're aiming how we're going to roll down the hill and smash the enemy. So we need all of you to get on board with your arrows and your slings. And so when we roll down this hill, we're going to take the enemy out. We're now going into offensive assault mode, ladies and gentlemen. And we are barbarians of truth. We're crazed. We're unapologetic. We foam at the mouth a little bit. And that's what it takes to 1776, the end.